What's going on, guys? It's Brandon back again for another video. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. By doing so, you're allowing other people to watch my videos, get exposure to the channel. You're helping me out, you're helping them out, and helping you guys out by encouraging me to make other videos. So if you could take a second and do that, that would be super appreciated. I just kind of wanted to make this video to kind of give you guys a little update on where things are at, what's going on. I know I had mentioned before the Golf, and we bought that $160 Golf and what my plans were with it. So I thought about it a lot yesterday, and I think what I'm going to end up doing today, I'm actually going to replace the crankshaft sensor. I got one from Pick and Pull, the $2 special, and I'm hoping that one is good so that I don't have to spend $80 on a part, because I mean, I got the car for $160. So I'm going to slap that in and make sure she fires up, and then I'm probably going to just try to clean things up. I've been trying to pick up another Mark III, but the guy's kind of flaking, for I found for $100, and I was essentially use the whole front end of the vehicle for the Golf to be able to straighten everything out, new bash bar or crash bar or whatever the hell you want to call it, the frame rail that was tweaked I'd be able to fix, new hood, headlights, bumper, everything. It was the same color, so it would have been sweet, and they said yes, and then they've just been kind of blowing me off. So you know how Craigslist goes. We're gonna try to figure that out as it comes. There's not too much left to do to it other than start cleaning it, and then I'm gonna try to sell it. That's my initial plan right off the bat. If it doesn't sell, then we'll make it a funky dunky car for the channel. The only reason I was really contemplating selling it is because I really want to get another car next year, and the more money I have put aside for it, the better, so that we can do things right away and I can buy a better quality car. My plan is basically to try to pick up an E36 or a 350Z that I can essentially drive to and from the track and be comfortable in, and do all that, so I can really focus on driving and not worry about trying to buy a trailer and doing all that kind of stuff, and basically taking out all the expenses that I would need in order to drift, and just be able to go out and have a good time and, you know, take it to work here and there once in a while, because I want to make my Jetta like this. Okay, not really like this. But as you can see, my garage is tore apart because we're throwing the motor in the VRT one more time. Andrew was kind enough to give us this motor, and we've been going through it the last few days. And now we just started reassembling everything, painting stuff up, cleaning it. And we're gonna throw it in the Jetta. So as you can see right here, this is the motor that was the mystery motor slapped in just to get the car here from my old house, and the pistons are shot there and there, pretty scorned up. Focus. It was causing immense blow by in Rob's motor, so it's basically undrivable. The car drove, but it smoked like crazy. So initially he was pulling the head off, hoping that it had to do with valves. Found out, obviously not. So we're gonna try to get that motor in, because Dubs Around the Lake is in 2 weeks, which is our next milestone. And that's kind of the big Volkswagen cruise. Thousands of Volkswagens go all the way around Tahoe and stuff. So we're gonna go ahead and hit that up. I have never been personally. Rob and Cameron have gone the last 2 years, I believe. So I'm super excited. My mom's watching Caden, and me and Kelly will have a good time in the Jetta. So there's a couple things I gotta knock out on my car. 3mm spacers so I can put my new brakes on, and upper strut mounts. I got some upgraded upper strut mounts to kind of help with that, with the bags and stuff like that. They kind of tend to wear out pretty fast, and they do anyways on Mark III, so I got a new fresh set of those. I'll probably knock those out this week. As for right now, I'm going to replace the knock sensor in the Golf. That way that thing is drivable and I can move it around the driveway instead of pushing it and fiddling with it just to get it to start. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So I guess I'll kind of show you guys how to do that, in case any of you ABA guys ever have to replace this. It's a common problem, about 130,000 miles on these cars. I've actually got one from Pick and Pull, because it's an $80 part, and I paid $160 for the car, so $2 to get a Pick and Pull, one hand, put it in my pocket, and let's give it a shot and hope it works. There's a Jetta. Ooh. All right, so if you guys haven't seen it, this is the $160 golf we picked up from up the hill. It wasn't running. The guy kind of got tired of it. It's clean title, but it has been damaged. Basically, some guy that had it on property used it to kind of get around his property and stuff. And it didn't run, and we got it running. But now we got to make it run permanently. So
I did grab another one of these fat daddies from Pick and Pull, but I guess I really didn't need to. It's just a hose that goes here that goes into the air box. Pressure washed the engine bay. All this shit came off, so that'll probably be getting painted. The sweet silver we used on the VR motor. But our task at hand is this guy. So this is how I was able to actually get the car. This is how I was actually able to get the car to start before. Typically this sits in here, and something is wacky with this harness to where if it has some tension left or right on the actual plug, it fires. And I believe it's because it's kind of grounding out right here on the oil filter housing. Right back there is where it's at. So I'm assuming that's what the issue was. Or the sensor itself is just bad, but I think it's grounding out because of the tension thing. So anyways, we're going to replace this with the one I got from Pick and Pull. And by doing so, hopefully, the car will run. Start right up every time. Well, it does run, but I won't have to, like, zip tie fucking harnesses up and do weird shit like that. So, in order to do this, if you guys are ABA guys and you want to know how to replace it, you got your front motor mount here, which is like a 16, I believe. We're going to need to bust that turret off and move this bracket out of our way. And then once we move the bracket out of our way, we can access it. I think it's a 5 millimeter. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Obviously you're gonna want a jack or something to support the motor so that the motor doesn't fall forward and smush your foot, because as much as people hate me, I work in flip-flops all the time. And next you're gonna have, basically you have to remove the starter so that you can get this whole bracket out of the way. So you're gonna have, looks like a 13 there, 16 there, and there should be on the bottom side like a 17, which is super long, and then that should be able to slide right out.
All right, so now you guys can see this is the old one. It doesn't look like damaged like I thought, so I'm guessing it's just bad, but this is super janky right here. It's hard to explain. But yeah, so fingers crossed. All right, ladies, here's the moment of truth. And she runs. So there's a little bit of a starter issue. But we have a check in July, so it could be numerous things that are making it hesitate a little bit on startup, but that was like the third time I did it. But she's running. Got some vacuum leaks I need to address. That could have been a fat issue right there. We'll be good. So I'm pretty pumped off that. Can't go wrong with now it's $162 car. Got a banging sound system though. Check it, ready?
And resort ticket, Disneyland ticket. Coming back, text Disney to 7339 to
that's
find
super
out
bass?
When
to win. Oh, here comes the super bass. I don't know if you guys can handle it. Alright guys, so this is going to conclude today's video. I know it's kind of short. Hopefully that will kind of help you guys that do have ABAs see how unintimidating that stuff is. You know, it was a really simple, easy install. I did it while Caden was napping. Didn't get too dirty. I always seem to get really dirty, but I didn't get too dirty. If the car was better maintained, I probably would not be as dirty as I am. But anyways, super easy. I'm super happy now. That's $162 and the car is running and starting. So I'm happy with that. Can't really beat that. Like I said before, I am probably gonna try to flip this car. So if I can get over $1,000, like around $1,500 for it, I'll probably let it go, to be honest. If I can't, once everything is squared away, then I'll probably just hold on to it because I can't really beat having a running and driving car for as cheap as it was. And it allows me to put the Jetta in the garage. Let me know what you guys want to see. If you guys would like to see me do like the lift and stupid stuff with this, if you're not really interested in it, or whatever the case may be. Either way, next year I'll be getting a rear-wheel drive project. It's just a matter of using funds from this to help get that, or have fun with this thing for the summer and then let it go. So let me know. Drop a comment below. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Until next time.